This is what 30 degrees looks like.
Linger whore. What the heck is that? That's a hardcore rider right there.
What up, Joes? How y'all doing? It is a little chilly. It is 30 degrees out right now. Oh my goodness. Gotta love winter, man. Gotta love winter. So you guys have been wondering, Jasmine, well, Jasmine needs a new chain. It's starting to get tight in certain areas and loose in others. And I need to lube it again. But I'm running out of lube.
Let's lube the other bike. The FZ10.
Now we're doing the FZ10. FZ10 chain. Can't wait until I get a garage. I need more lube.
It's done. It's done, y'all.
So what's going on today? We gonna go to Bikes and Breakfast. I haven't been out to Bikes and Breakfast for a long, long time. I've been going to all the Cars and Coffees, but we're going to Bikes and Breakfast, which is basically the same thing as Cars and Coffee, but Bikes and Breakfast. So we're gonna change it up a little bit. We're gonna do a motor vlog. It's gonna be real, real special though. You ready? Whoa! Look at that! We're in a new type of motorcycle. This is genius. Four wheels, and it has this shell kind of thing that keeps you away from the wind. It's awesome for 30 degree weather. Nice one, Jimbo. Thank you for scaring the shit out of me. We are going to
Bikes and Breakfast, babe.
Bikes and Breakfast, baby. So we'll see if anybody shows up with this 30 degree weather.
There's still gonna be people who do it. Gonna be people.
Some crazy people. Blinker whore.
Huh?
No, they had their blinker on. What the heck is that?
Those are toe clips.
Oh, okay. They look like balls to me.
Yeah, they really did.
That's a hardcore rider right there. It is 30 degrees out here.
Yeah.
There he goes.
Over there, I guess.
Okay, I'll turn it on.
The usually the burning smell that...
I don't smell a burning smell, I smell a weed smell.
Put it, if you have either, don't do it. Don't do it.
So this right here definitely wins the Bikes and Breakfast.
Yeah.
Coolest bike, I think, in my opinion. Look at this thing. GS1000.
I have to run her.
Grab something to eat.
That is a tiny...
Yeah, I haven't eaten anything yet.
That thing is sweet.
to be a cup holder.
Yeah.
Just put your coke right there.
Put your coffee, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Dude, that is sweet.
You wouldn't think of it, but this motorcycle, basically a bicycle that an engine was strapped to, was part of one of the most dangerous motorcycle races to date, and that's board track racing. It all started in 1910, went all the way to 1925, right before the Great Depression. This particular motorcycle is a replica that was powered by a single cylinder engine, basically half of a V-twin, was installed in a heavy duty bicycle frame, total weight of 65 to 70 pounds. And the interesting thing is they didn't have any brakes, and the engine operated at full throttle at all times. The only way that they could slow down was there was this switch on the left handlebar that could turn the throttle on and off. This particular motorcycle was named after the racer, Eddie Hasha, his nickname, the Texas Cyclone. And he was one of the more famous racers. One of these racers could make $20,000 a year, and that was a ton of money back then. It was kind of like being an NFL quarterback or something like that. We finished up with bikes and breakfast. Now we're going to Faux. Fuck you. So we had Pho. It was good. This place is actually pretty good.
What's up, motherfuckers?
Who do you think that is? It's a motherfucking turd bucket.
What's up, motherfuckers? How are you doing today?
Here's the bikes that came here today.
Sexy, sexy.
So this is Vic Maximus's...
Now I want my bike.
Really nice bike. This is the one that crashed, but now it looks freaking badass. Look at that. Look at that carbon fiber. Freaking amazing looking. Love the vents.
It's not my forte of business.
Just admiring your carbon fiber, baby.
I'm glad I got this. I didn't want to buy like cheap carbon fiber.
Yeah, just the best for Vic Maximus. Just the best.
That's expensive. Buy it here. They ordered from Germany.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. So it was like half price. It's ridiculous the markup that they have over here.
Oh my god. Half price?
Yeah.
So while I'm there,
shoot, man.
I have my other bike's wheel on it right now.
Uh-huh.
The back one is cast and all shiny. This one's forged, but because my my original one for this one has a big, like a thing, dent in it.
Oh yeah.
I was afraid it was gonna lose air and all that stuff, so I switched it out last night. But I was looking into buying a wheel.
Uh huh.
I called the dealer. $1,200.
Oh my god.
Oh yeah. So
I looked it in the website I ordered from in Germany.
Yeah.
Like $650.
For a new rim. Half price.
Yeah, I know, it's crazy.
That is crazy. Dang, man.
That's insane markup.
$600. Said it went through a fucking puddle. It's much better than $1,200.
I know. Insurance is like,
damn, I don't know if I can afford a BMW. But if you get it direct, I guess. Boom, half off. That's pretty awesome.
I might get a used one though, because I still don't want to spend that much money.
600, yeah.
Yeah, that's the way to go.
What do rims usually go for? Just 200?
Depends on the bike, but yeah, I think some of them are like 200.
Yeah.
The ones for my bike are like $1,200.
Damn!
Per wheel?
Well, if you get BMW,
like
make sure you got a lot of money.
Wheels.
Yeah, get ready to pay out the nose, because that's what I do.
Every day.
can check it out.
Good deal. Yeah, I think I saw one of your videos too.
Oh yeah?
I think you were coming here one time or something. And
okay, yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Good videos.
Cart, yeah.
Jogo 101?
Yep.
Hell yeah, dude.
Hey, what's up, bud?
I love your videos.
You follow you on Facebook.
Cool, man.
Yeah, cool.
I saw this on Twitter or on Instagram and I was just like, yes.